Hello again, and welcome to another video with the latest news and development in the Tesla universe. The video will cover Tesla's latest venture in the field of AI, the Tesla bot. Yes, you heard it right. This news was revealed in the annual Tesla AI Day in August of 2021. The news came as a surprise to many, and the expected due date for the Tesla bot was even more surprising, with Elon announcing that they might have a working prototype ready for distribution around 2023. The news was also a surprise because although Tesla has been venturing into various fields of automobile and mechatronics engineering, renewable energy and AI, it wasn't predicted that Tesla would make the dive into robotics this early, because it already has its plate full at the moment with a Cybertruck still pending its launch, expansion of Giga Berlin and Shanghai, not to mention construction of Giga Texas still in the pipeline, building the Megapack factory, fulfilling the battery production problems and countering issues with the microchip shortage. However, as always, Tesla once again put the world on notice with another mega announcement out of the blue. Although Tesla has been a world first in many innovations, it'll not be counted as the first car maker to delve into the field of robotics. Many automotive-centered conglomerates have ventured into the spheres of AI, machine learning, and robotics, and some are still spending and investing heavily in this area. The fruit of which is a rapid development, meteoric rise to be exact, in this discipline in just a matter of 50 years. The first company to reveal a robot capable of mimicking human gestures was the Honda Asimo, revealed over 2 decades ago in 2000. Meanwhile, Hyundai is also investing top dollar in robotics. Just last year, the South Korean automotive giant acquired Boston Dynamics, which is considered the world leader in developing and producing agile robots that have been utilized by many renowned firms across the globe. But don't count Tesla out of the game just yet. Tesla does have some cards up to its sleeves that might just make the elusive task of manufacturing and releasing the Tesla bot by next year a reality, seeing that Tesla is developing its own computer chips, which they have named the D1. The D1 is Tesla's patent microchip that'll be built on a 7-nanometer manufacturing process and will have around 362 teraflops of computing capacity. A teraflop is a measure of the computer's speed and power, translating to 1 trillion floating point operations per second. Using 25 D1 chips, one tile will be created and 120 tiles will be combined across server cabinets to provide computational power for the Dojo neural network that'll help Tesla's machines using the autopilot and FSD systems make smarter and more informed decisions that can closely mimic human-like behavior. That being said, many critics have pointed out that Tesla is being a tad overconfident in this matter by making such a bold claim that the robot will be ready by next year, considering all the bottlenecks already being faced by Tesla and their other projects such as the Cybertruck and the construction of Giga Berlin. Apart from that, Atlas, which is considered to be the world's most advanced bipedal robot developed by Hyundai subsidiary and Tesla competitor Boston Dynamics, is still considered a prototype that's part of research and development, and not a final form ready for mass production and distribution even after 10 years of development. This humbleness is laying claims has put Boston Dynamics, and in turn Hyundai, in the safer side in case the project goes downhill or any other unwanted result occurs. Compared to that, Musk has made a bolder claim in saying that he might have a working Model 2 and ready for distribution by this time next year. In effect, he's saying that he can trump Boston Dynamics' 10 years worth of research in just 1 year. Some, however, are not taking this claim to heart, as they know Elon is a master at bait-and-switch tactics. Just take a look at the Hyperloop or the Cybertruck as an example. At the start of things, Elon proposed that the Hyperloop would be like a giant hosepipe through which a train-shaped carrier will zip through at supersonic speeds. But after many revisions and changes, it has been now projected to be something like the Autobahn in Germany, but in an encapsulated or closed space where enthusiasts can drive their cars at top speeds. It was also claimed that the Tesla bot will be able to follow voice commands intuitively utilizing the Dojo neural networks that are currently under development, something similar to Sophia, the world-acclaimed smart conversational robot. Although in essence, Sophia herself is a chatbot like Eliza, which could mimic human conversation. However, her computer vision sets her apart, meaning that she can observe and follow her surroundings. She also has an array of human facial expressions, 60 to be exact, that keeps the audience engaged with her during conversations. This may have prompted conspiracy theorists to hypothesize a rise of the machines. However, Ben Gortzel, one of the key people who helped create Sophia, once himself remarked, "If I show them a beautiful smiling robot face, then they get the feeling that AGI or artificial general intelligence may indeed be nearby and viable. None of this is what I would call AGI, but nor is it simple to get working." The chief of Hanson Robotics, however, said, Sophia OS basically alive, to which Bertzel rebutted that even a sculpture is alive to its creator. In some aspects, Musk's strategy is somewhat similar to Hanson Robotics, the developers of Sophia, the talking robot. As discussed in previous videos, it's all about the hype. The hype is what gets the people in the market moving and spikes up the stocks. That's why sometimes this deliberate bluff is used to get the stocks pumped up. Another negative which was picked up by commentators was the fact that Musk didn't even use a proper machine. He didn't have any prototype or anything, instead he used a human mascot in a spandex suit to kick off his presentation, which was lampooned by critics across the globe. Some go so far as to say that Tesla bot presentation was tomfoolery on another level. The expected specifications for the Tesla bot were also revealed in the presentation as well. The Tesla bot will have a height equal to the average human height of 5 feet and 8 inches and will weigh around 125 pounds or 56.9 kilograms. The Tesla bot will have a top speed of 5 miles per hour. At this point, Elon Musk himself jokingly remarked that anyone with the ability to run faster than 5 miles an hour will be safe from the machine. At the moment, its carry capacity is set to 45 pounds and its deadlifting capacity is around 150 pounds, which is well below even an intermediate level gym goer. But enough to make it able to lift rubble off a victim in disaster situations, as it can be used as a first responder in the future. This should rule out any conspiracy theories about an apocalyptic scenario, a brigade of Tesla bots leading a rise of the machines, where robots with super strength will go about manhandling humans and putting them in human pens. The Tesla bot will have an arm extended lift of about 10 pounds, meaning it can lift a weight of 10 pounds with its arm held completely perpendicular to its body. It'll have a display screen on the head instead of facial features where it'll display useful information like battery percentage and alert messages like any error encountered by its operating system during performance of any task. The Tesla bot features 40 actuators, 12 each for arms, legs, and hands, and remaining 4 for the torso and neck. Despite all this equipment, which includes a mainframe that houses its processing equipment, a number of motors for limb movement, actuators, and other miniature machinery, it's made up of lightweight materials that help keep its weight below the average American. It'll be designed with human-level hands, mimicking triple joint movement capabilities of the human finger, meaning it can curl its finger under three joints just like a human can. This is a pretty unique feature compared to its competitors. It'll also feature dual-axis feed balancing with force feedback sensing, meaning that the bot will have sensory feedback that'll help keep it from stumbling in case it encounters an obstacle. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Despite being one of the most dedicated entrepreneurs in the AI discipline, Elon is strictly against the use of AI as weaponry and calls it the greatest peril we ever faced. But he justifies the Tesla bot as a positive use of AI and endorses similar positive uses of AI that can facilitate humans by minimizing human involvement in monotonous and hazardous tasks. This will be a game changer in the global economy, according to Musk, as according to him, AI and robots will capture the labor market in the future, which will result in a need of a universal basic income for the humans, and that physical labor will be more of a choice rather than an obligation. What do you think? Do you think that robots will capture the labor market in the future? Do you think that universal basic income will be a viable concept for the global economy? Will Tesla be able to launch the bot by next year? Leave your comments below.